to see you again.
Thank you. Nice to see you.
And congratulations. You got a new baby.
Yes, I do, yeah.
You're a dad.
Yes, I'm a dad.
And the baby's name is it Lily Rose?
Lily Rose.
Okay, how old is Lily Rose?
6 months.
6 months. So do you like it? Are you into the whole thing? Are you having a good time?
Yeah, oh yeah, I'm having a good time. Yeah, you have a good time when you become a father.
Yeah, yeah. Are you spoiling her?
A little bit.
Yeah.
A little bit. It's safe to say yeah.
Yeah, that'd be yeah. Like, what do you do?
I very recently had two-hour sessions at FAO Schwartz.
Oh, the big toy store, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. Where I bought, I mean, an inordinate amount of presents. I mean, just huge, yeah.
And she's 6 months.
And then I gave them to her.
Already. You gave them to her already?
They were going to be for Christmas, and I gave them to her already, so I have to go back. I
think you missed last Christmas.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So now you have to go back and buy more toys.
Yes, I do. I do.
What was your favorite toy as a kid? Did you have a favorite toy?
Yeah, I did, in fact. I was always sort of drawn to, this may be shocking, I was always sort of drawn to, like, Dracula and Frankenstein.
Dracula, Frankenstein? Why am I not shocked at all?
Yeah.
Did you have the action figures?
Yes, yeah. I had the models, I had everything.
Did you make them do stuff, or what did you do?
What kind of stuff?
Well, you know,
what are you insinuating?
Well, like Dracula, you cover with gasoline and throw him off the roof, you know?
No, none of that? No. But I did have,
What were you thinking?
One of my favorite toys later on was an Evel Knievel wind-up toy. You wind him up and then...
The bike would do a wheelie and take off.
Yeah, and he crashes into stuff.
Yeah, that's a good one, too. You cover with gasoline and then crash into stuff.
Yeah, you have this obsession with
gasoline. Or you put an M80 under it, and then you roll it into your, you know, like into your sister's bedroom and you blow it up.
Oh, my God.
And you have, like, a bug collection, too.
I do, yes. I do have a bug collection.
Now, are these things you got just from being a single guy or actually collected the bugs?
Yeah, I was lonely and I just got a hold of some bugs, yeah. I don't know, I have a kind of a profound respect for bugs.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, based on...
Well,
you work with them in a film? I mean,
No. I don't know, I think it's good to make friends with the only... people who will survive, the only creatures that will survive in the end.
Well, they would be good
enough. Cockroach.
Like, what do you have? What kind of bugs do you have?
I have an enormous cockroach, very dead.
An enormous cockroach?
Yeah, he's about...
That looked the size of a small dog, the way you did it.
He's about like that.
Yeah,
that's
a big cockroach.
That's an enormous cockroach, yeah.
Now, I got you some bugs. I know you like bugs. If you can name these bugs, I will give you these bugs. These are very rare.
If I can name the bugs?
What is
name that bug.
That is a real bug.
That is a real bug. Well, it's a butterfly.
Yeah.
That's a...
What kind?
That's a birdwing butterfly.
A bird... That's very good. That's very good. You get the birdwing. Put it right there on the chair.
New Guinea.
Hey, let's cover it with gas and throw them off the roof. Yeah. Can you identify that? See how
that
good
is you. That is a giant grasshopper.
From?
That's from Mexico. Senor.
Yes, Mexico. That's very good. Give me those.
I know my
actually, I brought you one from under my bed. This is a real bug. This is really creepy. Look at that. That's a real. Would you like that for your collection? That's a real.
In fact, he smells like gasoline.
No. That's a real.
Spend some time with.
No, that's a real one. That's a real one. That's a real one. Isn't that creepy?
Yeah, I'd rather not.
Would you like to find that in your underpants, huh? Oh, man.
In your underpants.
Yeah, that'd be scary. Who did I go out with? Now, I want to talk to you about Sleepy Hollow. I really like... Because, you know, I see every movie, and sometimes you have to kind of go... And I don't know what to expect on this
Sometimes
film.
You have to lie later and say... Oh,
yeah,
great.
You do. Yeah. Or you kind of go, you were good. You know, but no, but you were good. No. No, but this is... Because I like Tim Burton. I like how authentic this movie... It takes place in about the year, 1799?
Yes. Right?
And all the people are like kind of that, kind of dirty and creepy and eerie, and it has a great, great look to it. Now, obviously, Tim Burton, you work with him many times, so I guess you're real comfortable with him.
Oh, yeah. It's our third time together.
Now, tell people basically what the film is about.
Well, it's the very famous story, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, Ichabod Crane and the Headless Horseman.
Right.
Sort of gruesome, grisly murders, bizarre murders happening in small town in upstate New York.
Is it very serious on the set? Is it heavy, or do you have, are you loose? Do you have fun on the set like this, or is everybody sort of...
No, no, we cackled like infants. Yeah, no, we laughed. No, we laughed every day. It was such a good time.
Tim told me you like, was it Georgie Jessel?
Yes,
Do you know who Georgie Jessel is? Kids don't even know who it is. That lady giving her age, she went, oh. He's like an old, he was like 80 when I was a kid.
I remember watching Georgie Jessel on television. Yeah, Tim and I had a kind of a bizarre obsession with Georgie Jessel.
Yeah.
And it got so bad, we used to imitate him all the time. And it got so bad that you know, you'd be getting ready to walk in front of the camera to do a scene, and the guy would be doing the sticks, and you're waiting for action, and suddenly you just hear, and action! And it was, impossible, to walk in the scene after that. And then you'd do the scene, and then you hear, and cut! And Tim,
Right,
Tim.
That's right. Yeah. See, half the audience going...
You got to provide them with all the Georgie Jessel tapes.
Now this clip we're going to see, what scene? Oh, this is the scene where you're talking to the man. You don't believe in the Headless Horseman. You're a detective, right? You think this whole thing is phony baloney.
Yes, I think this is the point when I'm sort of forced to believe. This is the moment of the film.
And the horseman is really scary.
He's riding.
And that's what's really great about it, because sometimes you see movies of giant monsters, and just a guy with no head is scarier than any of these things. Here, take a look. Take a look. Here's a scene from Sleepy Hollow.
What are you running from, Magistrate Phillips?
Damn you, Crane.
Well, terrific job.
Thank you.
Really enjoyed the film. The film is called Sleepy Hollow, and it opens tomorrow night.
Yes.
Tomorrow night. I know you have to run. You want to take these bugs with you?
Wow, thank you.
Here you go. You can put these in your collection. For the baby.
Thank you.